Hello, good morning. We're at GAD 2015. Good morning, Mr. Lam.
Hi, how are you?
The burning question that everybody has is about your third runway program that we read a lot about in the press. So I was hoping you could tell us a little bit more about this big project.
I would love to. Our expansion plan, we call it the three runway systems. It's actually more than just building another runway. We are really trying to build almost like a new airport right next to the existing one. It would have a new runway, it would have a new concourse of 270,000 square meters in size. It also would have a new automated people mover to connect the concourse to the new terminal. So the whole thing would the whole construction period would last 8 years. And when complete, this new facility would help us to increase our handling capacity to over 100 million people, and also 9 million tons of cargo. So we're very excited about this project because obviously Hong Kong International Airport is really at the core of Hong Kong's competitiveness.
Indeed.
And we believe that with this new expansion, we will be able to continue to support Hong Kong's economic development.
And is it true that with 100 million passengers, it would really be one of the biggest airports in Asia, in fact?
With 100 million passengers, we believe that it will be one of the largest international passenger airport. In terms of cargo, we are already the largest in the world. And if we are able to increase our capacity to 9 million tons, then I believe we will continue to hold that position for some years to come.
Exactly. But this project, it's going to be very expensive, right? It's going to be very expensive for the city of Hong Kong. Also, it's going to have quite a lot of challenges in terms of building the actual infrastructure. So can you tell us a bit more about how you see these challenges and what you think needs to be done to overcome them?
This would indeed be the most expensive infrastructural projects that Hong Kong have ever seen. It's going to cost $18 billion to build. Because trying to build a new airport right next to the existing is very challenging. And also because we care also a lot about preserving the environment. We want to make sure that there's a right balance between economic development and also the preservation of the environment. So we are now using a lot of the reclamation methods that actually would not disturb the marine life in the area where we're going to build the new airport. Those measures are actually very important to reassure our community that the airport's development would both be good for Hong Kong in the long run, and as well as it's also, we will do all we can to preserve the environment. And so environment will be one very important challenge that we have to overcome. But at the same time, financing is also an issue.
Yes.
Because $18 billion, US dollars is a lot of money. We would like to see whether we could actually finance that from our own resources without the need to go to the government for any help.
So financing out of the cash flow and using commercial debt.
That's right. So basically, we're going to do it in three ways. Firstly, I think we're going to plow back the surplus that we generate every year into this project. And that would account for about one third of the funding need. We are also going to charge a new airport construction charge on passengers. Obviously, we'll keep that very low to make sure that it would not scare away the passengers. But that itself will also help to cover some of the costs. But the bulk of the funding will come from commercial borrowing, will come from the issuance of bonds. We hope that this would cover almost 50% of our entire funding need. But because our airport enjoys a very high credit rating.
Yes.
And also because it's also a profitable venture, we believe that this is probably the best way to finance this expansion project.
Right. So just one last question is, clearly with that large sum of money, you cannot really afford to have too much of like a budget overrun or other risk materialize, right? Because it sounds like if you want to finance it without government support, you don't want any of that. So is it too early to say, or are there already, is there anything special that you are doing to control this difficult situation?
This is again a very important issue for us. How are we going to really control the cost of the project? Obviously, for any major infrastructure project of this nature, nobody can guarantee that there won't be any cost overrun at the outset. But I believe that if we do our plannings right, if we actually take enough mitigation measures in advance, we could actually reduce this risk to a minimum. That would include things like that we're going to do sufficient site investigation to making sure that we understand the seabed conditions, so that actually when we then try to build this, there won't be any nasty surprises. We need to have a very robust program, costing structure, as well as a team to manage it, to making sure that if there's ever any issues, we can deal with that very quickly. And I think last thing is that we also have to make sure that we are not going to change our design halfway through the construction, because that's also
changes is
not always the reason for a budget overrun, which means that again at this stage, at the planning stage, we need to make sure that our operation team and the product team knows exactly what we are going into, understand what are our future requirements, and we want to make sure that we have this design freeze very early on. And we hope that this would help to reduce the cost overrun risk to a minimum.
Exactly. So does that mean that you are actually also working a lot with the airlines and trying to understand like what is going to be the split of transfer between O&D traffic in the future? Because these are going to drive the design choices, right?
We have already done a lot of that planning. But apart from that, of course, that's one aspect of it. But we also must have a good understanding of what technology is now driving the airport design. New generation of airport users are going to be very different from our generation, right?
Exactly.
They are going to use a lot of self-service.
Yes.
So how is that going to impact on the counter setup? Also with smartphones, with a lot of the tracking technologies, the future design of the airport and future usage of the airport will be very different. And we hope that when this new expansion is complete, it's not only going to be one of the largest in the world, it will also be the smartest in the world.
Exactly. So it's going to be even more beautiful than the current airport.
I hope so too.